My first question to Dr. Dolan, you've recommended that the minimum should be increased from, let's say, a $10 overpayment to $25. And I guess it's a two-part question. And what is the basis for that? And simply, if it's the threshold is really low, obviously you have multiple claims being challenged and overpayments and such. I understand that. Is it worth it even at $25 for the physician to go through all the trouble to basically contest it? That's the first question. The other thing is, if you don't contest and you just simply pay, are you establishing some sort of record in that big computer in the sky or whatever that, you know, Dr. Dolan, because you just didn't want to contest all these low ones or even cumulatively, it just was not worth the expense? Is there some fear on the part of a physician that somehow they're having some sort of a record out there for someone to look, and it obviously would not be a good reflection that you had 1,000 claims, maybe they're all $10 or whatever, nevertheless, there is no distinction. Is that a fear? But let's just go back to, you want to increase it from 10 to 25, and what would be the basis for that?
I personally would want to increase it to $100. I mean, at $10, the physician will lose money. I mean, just listen to the story next door here. Will lose money in even trying to replicate the records. Remember, we do not get paid like the hospitals get paid for replicating the records, nor the postage, nor anything else. So you will lose quite a bit of money, even if you have to do one record. It's just not worth it. It's like us seeing Medicaid patients. It's not worth it to charge. We do it for free. Same with $25. With all the work you have to do, it's probably not worth paying a full-time equivalent to go back, find the record, $15 an hour payment, to file and then copy all those things and then get the postage and send it off, filling out all the forms. It's not worth it. We know of no such dragon in the sky who is watching over this. There may be, but if you're just dealing with several items, unlike the multiple requests by the doctor, I would just blow it away. It's not worth my time. It's not worth my secretary's time. It's not worth the patient's inconvenience. So I would do that. Now, PPAC, who is the Physicians Advisory Council to CMS, has recommended $25. That's where the $25 came in. But personally, I'd go higher than that, because that's when you're really going to fight if it gets to be $100. But that's where that number came in. It's an arbitrary number, and I'll have to say that to that.
The fear, of course, if you're on contingency basis and you go for all this, let's just say, low-hanging fruit, but the real reason is simply that you know it's not going to be contested, and you just cumulatively you can make a lot of money, to be honest with you, because the side that obviously, or the other side, is it's just not financially a viable proposition for them. I will instruct committee staff, if they will remind me to follow up as to how CMS keeps these statistics and whether there is any adverse effect on someone. In other words, if there's a future, let's say, investigation or whatever it is, they go back and they go, my gosh, look at all these claims, not looking at the numbers or anything like that. So is a physician or a healthcare provider placed in jeopardy by simply making that determination of not to oppose or to appeal or so on? I think that's a real concern. At the end of the day, you're still a business. I mean, you're a last-standing profession. I always say that, but nevertheless, there are business considerations. Then, Mr. Wiesner, let me ask, I'm trying to figure this thing out on the average manufacturer's price and how it plays out, and the